Good morning, guys. Here we are, second day, Sunday. Bit of rain overnight, a bit of drizzle in the air. Might affect the water a little bit. It's a funny old place, Evesham, on the Sunday, you know, after the Saturday match. People sometimes think, well, it's not going to fish, but it's quite often it does. As I say, yesterday was a lot of 7 pounds weights, you know, and so let's hope it's more of the same today. All down to the draw, of course. So anyway, just arrived, so let's go make my way to the draw. Okay.
And if you know you're the last man leaving, will you put the pole back up, please? And we'll lock it later. If you're on the town, please drive onto the meadow, but do not cross the footpath to park your car for whatever. We're fishing 12 till 5. And if you want a car park ticket so that you don't have to pay on the town from pegs 1 to 40, please go and see Sue. She's sitting at the table there and she will give you a car parking ticket for free. Okay, thank you all very much and may the best man win.
Oh, did you?
Jim Kay is on peg 83. Is on peg 77.
Yeah. Are you good yesterday?
No. I drew 10 Wednesday, 11 yesterday. Caught on the hemp.
You caught on the hemp?
Yeah. 8 on the trot, then I had best roach and a pike at it.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Oh, yeah. That one there.
60.
It's on peg 60. Yeah.
Okay, there you go. As I say, sometimes your luck's in, sometimes it's not, and unfortunately my bad luck again, peg 60. He didn't weigh in yet off it yesterday. But yeah. The only good thing I can say is that my section starts from 58 and finishes at 62. And the reason why, 63 normally always wins that section, so that's not in today. So give me a little bit of a scope to try and go for my little mini section. Okay, I've drawn peg 60 before and it's really a struggle, like, you know. Let's go and have a look and I'll see. I just had a word with the gardener who won the match yesterday and he lives on, he knows the water, back of his hand, and he's given me a little bit of advice. You know, he said fish on the inside for the, you know, in the lilies, catch a few perch. He said, go across, there might be some chublets across, he said, and a waggler. And then sit out for maybe a tench on the inside or something. So we shall see. Give it a go anyway. See you at the peg. Okay, here's peg 60. Oh, little duckling with a duckling. Little chicks. Morning. Yeah. Okay.
Is it a big competition today?
Yes.
When you say big, I know about much about fishing as going in a fish and chip shop.
Well, there's about 80 anglers here, so you know.
From
right from at the top, right down past the cricket pitch.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What area is it? A Midlands area? Or?
All over. I'm from South Wales, from Cardiff, but a lot of people from, you know, sort of everywhere, London and. You know, yeah, it's we're trying to qualify for a big competition for the bank holiday weekend when the winner picks up about £5,000. So, you know, that's
So, you're a semi professional?
Well, I'm a former world champion.
Shitting me,
yeah.
I feel like I should pick the
best.
Or something.
Always pick the best person to speak to. Yes, no, I come here quite often because it's the centre of the Midlands of match fishing, you know, and this river, it's fished every day, and you know, yesterday there was a competition on you yesterday, yeah. I just missed out yesterday on the main prizes, but you know. So.
When you say world champion, you mean the world?
Yeah.
Not like the American world.
No. World championships. I was in Portugal. It was a few years ago now, in 1987. Yeah, in 1986 I was runner up. I had a silver medal, and then the following year I had the gold. So you know. Yeah. So I had a couple of good years in my younger days. Yes, I do. Yeah. Okay, that was nice, isn't it? General public stopping and asking questions, you know, about the fishing. And they found it quite interesting. And they found it interesting to see so many nutters on the riverbank in a dank, a dreary morning, like. But no, they thought it was interesting. Just explaining to them how it operates and how it works, you know. That's good. Yeah, anyway, I'm going to tackle up now. My approach would be like the... I got a nice lily bed there. So I might have a go behind there for some perch. Maybe a tencher, who knows. But I don't give it much hope, to be quite honest, because I fished it the year before and I drew the peg below. And I think one match, Mark Downs had this peg, and I had the one below him, and I did beat him. Went across on a little feeder and had a few perch. So I'll do the same. There's a bit of a lily pad there today over there, so I got a target to go for. Yeah, true enough. Don't know if you can see that. It's just a small lily pad, but gives me a target to go for. Let's hope it's not too snaggy. I have seen small roach here, but not enough to win anything. So it'll be perch on the inside. Hopefully there might be a tench, who knows. There's only one caught yesterday. And across there, more perch and some chublets up in the water with a waggler, hopefully. So hope this wind don't pick up too much, because then I'll be able to fish the waggler okay, but the wind is always a problem, you know. Yeah. Okay, right, all ready to go now. 10 minutes to start, so... gives me an opportunity really to go through with a few rigs and things I'm doing. Now the only thing is, it's the sort of swim that, you know, you know you're not going to catch a lot, but you'd need to set up an array of different tackle and tactics. Now, the first thing, of course, which I'll probably be having a go at, and that's the feeder. It's a little block end feeder. And it's on a loop method, and I've got about 18 inches of tail. And what I've done, I've gone up a bit heavier than yesterday. Yesterday I was using 11 diameter bottoms, and I've gone up to 12 on this one, only because if you manage to get one of them bullies or the bigger fish, you know, at least you got less chance of snapping you. Like yesterday, I got snapped twice on the strike, or if you like, on the bite, where the rods bounce back, and I've come back with no hook length, and that's happened twice, which cost me second place yesterday, but there, never mind, that's one of them things. Don't dwell on it too much. Now, I'm going to show you a little something that I do. Now, it's a medium-sized feeder. Yeah, I'll show you now. Right, it's a medium-sized feeder. Now, the thing is, it's too big, if you like, to put a lot of bait in. if you're on the river, you know, where it's fast flowing, then yeah, they're fine. But when it's a bit still like this, what you need to do, need to pinch maggot in. But what I do, I put hemp. Basically, I fill it half with hemp. Well, first of all, I put the maggots in and I put hemp on the top to pack it up. So that reduces the amount of feed in the feeder. And also it gives a little bit extra weight, and also gives a little bit of smell, if you like, into the hemp, into the water, into the swim. And that's something I've done yesterday, and I'll do it again today. I'll be fishing to the far side. I'm hoping it's not too snaggy, because where there's lilies, there's probably, you know, stick-ups and bits of weed. So anyway, that's going to be my one tactic. So that I'll be doing throughout the match. I may even start on that. If I don't start on that, I'm going to start on an inside swim, which is basically, I think there's so many rigs set up, yeah? which will probably be, now this is my inside perch rig. Just on the lilies, on the inside lilies, and well, again, I geared up on this as well. Got a puller bung on it. Got a size 14 hook, and I'm going to put some worm in, chop worm in, and see if I can catch any, you know, perch or billies, as Billy Makin used to say, the famous rugby player. That's where his name came from. The name of the. If you haven't seen that vlog. Go back and view that. Like, well, actually, it's in my in my book. I may have written about it in my book. If not, it'd be probably in my next book. Anyway, so that's my inside rig. For no, the other thing is the chance if I do get a tench. That's the reason I got the puller bung, because one of the boys yesterday, Robert McKenzie, was on the peg, two pegs up, and he's had a tench. And lucky enough, he had a puller bung and he managed to get it in. Otherwise, he would have probably lost it, he said. So that's my little inside rig. Now, my long rig is 13 metres. And what I've done, I've set up a very light reverse pair. No, sorry, not reverse, because it's not towing through enough. If it was towing through a lot, then I'd use a reverse pair to, you know, just hold it against the flow so the current goes off the top. Instead, I'm using a pear shape, and that's set at about 14 foot deep. And basically, that's my the reason I set this up, by the way, last time I was here, there was a lot of little roach to be caught on the ground bait on the inside. Now, as I said, they're not really showing yet, not the bigger roach anyway, not the hemp size roach. So that's another option that I'll try out at 14 metres. I'll cup in a couple of balls and then I'll run through that. Then I've got an inside rig, third button, which is a pencil float. And this I can use either over the top of my ground bait, or I've got a nice inside line. I'm going to fish, you know, with their loose feed pinkies, you know, to pick up any small fish on the inside. Right, then I can't show you this. This is an Avon float that I set up, and with a bog down. Okay, it's six number BBs, and I'm using basically an Avon float. I was thinking of a Bolly. But I think an Avon will suit it better. Yeah, basically, yeah. And there's my Avon float. Now this I'm going to use either down the middle or over my pole line if I need to sort of trot further down swim. So that gives me another little extra option. Again, I'm using small hooks, pinkies, you know, to pick up little roach. Because I think that's what we're going to catch here. The other option causes eels on the feeder and perch, hopefully, which I'll catch either on the inside or across. And that's about it, really. So I've got the array of tackle set up, different methods I'll be trying throughout the match. Not long ago now, 5 minutes ago, so I'll sign off now and I'll see you at the start of the match.
Supervisor, said you've got five left.
Yeah.
But you said you've only counted water in that five. Yeah. Out of the original five. So you've got to think, well, that'll be right then, because you'll have three for other three that's with water. And now each of them is your five.
Yeah, but I
think
you
thank you.
się stro, nie da się nim rugać.
Chance if I go with all these boats going on. Okay, well, a bit of a short vlog today because I've ended up, as you can see, struggling really. Just I've had one tommy ruff, one perch, and half a dozen little daisy things about that big. It's been really, really hard for a lot of people along here. The guy below me's had two eels, so I think he might probably win the section. So I'm afraid it's one of them days that not much to show. I won't be troubling the scalesman today. Never mind, there's always the Twyford Festival. That's 2 days. That's tomorrow and Tuesday. That's Monday and Tuesday. And then on the 7th on Wednesday. So there you are. Well, thanks for watching, even though I can't really show you a lot. I'll just show you my fish now, and I'll see you next time.